We're going to learn all about multiplying and dividing fractions. First, let's focus on dividing fractions. But before we understand how dividing fractions works, we need to learn about something called reciprocals. A reciprocal is just a math term for what you get when you switch the top and bottom numbers of a fraction. For example, if you have the fraction 2 over 5, and you switch the top and bottom numbers, you'll end up with 5 over 2. 2 over 5 is the reciprocal of 5 over 2. And 5 over 2 is the reciprocal of 2 over 5. One interesting thing about reciprocals is that when you multiply a fraction by its own reciprocal, you always get one. This happens because you have the same numbers being multiplied on the top and the bottom, so they cancel each other out, leaving you with a whole, which is always equal to 1. Alright, that's pretty cool, but what do reciprocals have to do with dividing fractions? Well, reciprocals help us use a neat trick that makes dividing fractions super easy. Whenever you need to divide by a fraction, you can just flip the fraction and multiply instead. This way, you'll still get the right answer without the extra step. And that's awesome news because multiplying fractions is really straightforward. As always, let's look at a couple of examples to see how this works so you'll really get it. Let's try this one. 6 over 7 divided by 8 over 10. First, we need to rewrite the problem. Instead of dividing by 8 over 10, we'll multiply by its reciprocal. The reciprocal of 8 over 10 is 10 over 8. So our new problem is 6 over 7 multiplied by 10 over 8. Oh, here's something important to remember. A common mistake students make when they first learn to divide fractions is flipping the wrong fraction. Sometimes they take the reciprocal of the first fraction, the one being divided, or even flip both fractions, but you should only flip the second fraction, the one you are dividing by. Alright, now that we've changed the problem to multiplication, it's simple. Just multiply the numerators, 6 times 10 equals 60, and multiply the denominators, 7 times 8 equals 56. So, the answer to 6 over 7 divided by 8 over 10 is 60 over 56. Let's look at another example. 3 over 5 divided by 12 over 20. First, rewrite the problem. Instead of dividing by 12 over 20, we'll multiply by its reciprocal. The reciprocal of 12 over 20 is 20 over 12. So, our new problem is 3 over 5 multiplied by 20 over 12. Next, multiply the numerators. 3 times 20 equals 60. Then, multiply the denominators. 5 times 12 equals 60. So 3 over 5 divided by 12 over 20 equals 60 over 60. And what is 60 over 60? It's just 1 because the top and bottom are the same. Now you've learned how to divide fractions using the reciprocal trick. Let's quickly remember how it goes. Step 1. Keep the first fraction as it is. Step 2. Flip the second fraction. Find its reciprocal. Step 3. Change the division to multiplication. Step 4. Multiply the tops and the bottoms. Step 5. Simplify your answer if you can. So when you see a fraction division problem, just keep it, flip it, and multiply. Now that you're comfortable with dividing fractions, multiplying fractions will feel even easier because it's just straightforward multiplying without flipping anything. Multiplying fractions is super simple. There's no flipping this time. Here's how it works. Step 1. Multiply the numerators, the top numbers. Step 2. Multiply the denominators, the bottom numbers. Step 3. Simplify your answer if you can. Let's see an example. Let's multiply another pair of fractions. Multiply 2 over 3 by 4 over 5. First, multiply the top numbers. 2 times 4 equals 8. Next, multiply the bottom numbers. 3 times 5 equals 15. So, 2 over 3 multiplied by 4 over 5 equals 8 over 15. And that's it, nice and easy. That's it. Easy, right? Another example. Let's try another example. Multiply 3 over 7 by 2 over 9. First, multiply the top numbers. 3 times 2 equals 6. Next, multiply the bottom numbers. 7 times 9 equals 63. So 3 over 7 multiplied by 2 over 9 equals 6 over 63. And that's how you multiply fractions. Just multiply the tops, multiply the bottoms, and reduce if you can. Now you know how to divide fractions using reciprocals and how to multiply fractions the easy way.